All right, hey guys, Seabags here, doing another RD2L group stage cast. It is game two of Takes Two to Tango, also known as Four Tangos, because I don't remember any other way, and their abbreviation is 4T. It's easier for me to remember. And Cleanup Crew, game one went in favor of 4T, just barely. Cleanup Crew had a huge advantage, but after a bit of cocky mistakes in terms of item picks, in terms of overextension, in terms of pushing, they threw it. In the end, I'm sure they'll learn from their mistakes, and that's what this experience is just about all about. But anyways, Takes Two to Tango, they ban out the OD. They're tired of the shenanigans, and that's a respect, man. The OD pick was really nice, but he scaled off somewhat to the end. Just could not match the deeps of the Weaver or the Luna. Takes Two to Tango, they go instantly with the Alchemist and CM. Like, no hesitation whatsoever. Two, possibly carry, possibly support. The Melk Award for Takes Two to Tango goes to Jimmy. Like, he landed some nice stuns, but at one point I think it was like 0-12 and like 14 or something like that. For sure, not the most impressive KDA in the world. But Death Prophet gets the first pickup for Cleanup Crew. I'm very surprised with this early pickup for Death Prophet. This is normally Death Prophet doesn't get that much respect. I don't think she's worth first round picks, in my opinion, but I guess you can, you know, wrap your mind around this. I wouldn't be surprised if we see, like, maybe a Dragonite to try to tank some things up. But they really want to go with the Undying once again. They're looking to end early. Last time they didn't really have that damage to the push, and now I guess they want to do this. But this time they're pretty sure they're going to run an aggressive tri-lane. Their aggressive tri-lane last time was stronger. They did get, like, a tri-lane wipe. Rotation from Remorse, they kind of save it a little bit, but again, Cleanup Crew won the tri-lane hard with the Undying. We'll see what kind of combo they go this time. They could go Rubick. I like the Rubick Undying combination. We'll see if that gets through this time. Clockwork still in the pull. It could be a very viable hero. Timbersaw, I think, as well. He did really well. I mean, he created a lot of space, really dished out a lot of mid game damage, but already. They're really oriented for this mid game. Cleanup Crew, their last lineup was very mid game. So Timbersaw in the pull, Clockwork in the pull, Windrunner in the pull. It's kind of hard to say what they want to go for. Slark in the pull. Keep that in mind. We could see a Brood as well, and Brood is hell yeah annoying. And okay, it's a Pugnite here for Takes Two to Tango. I like this pickup, and I almost want to see a DK. The Chinese style. Again, I always comment on it because I think it's an amazing strategy to go Pugna tri-lane farm with the DK mid, and then you basically get the levels and you place a ward because you need all those all that mana to spam down creep waves early mid game. The ward like at level 4 is just a ridiculous amount of damage, and Prophet will take a lot because she will be spamming that crypt swarm quite a bit. Undying has to spam quite a bit as well. And we'll see what they go with. For secondary support, of course, Rubick is nice. You got Rubick, and there's a lot of good spells to steal. Anything from Crystal Maiden. Clockwork, okay. Again, good hero. There's the life there, so that will be the tri-lane farmer. Looks like Pugna will be support. I always don't like that. I mean, possible changeup. They could go for a 2-1-2 with, I don't know, whoever missed. So Razor's going to be... So where do you lane this? Either you put Razor mid, but the Razor is kind of a counterpick to the Lifestealer. That's pretty good. You could have the Death Prophet mid. Both aren't bad. I think possibly having the Razor mid is a better choice. Yeah, Razor mid with the Death Prophet in the tri-lane farming role. But again, this is that mid-game oriented build. Of course, Razor, if he gets like a refresher eggs, he'll raffle stomp your towers and racks and buildings. That'll be funny. And a lot of people underestimate his damage. But a Bane gets banned out for Takes Two to Tango. Just want to counter the Lifestealer, although I don't expect them to pick Bane anyways. Windrunner is finally there. This looks to be their offlane hero. Yeah, offlane Windrunner, Naix, Alchemist, CM, Tri-lane, Pugna mid. They could put the Alchemist mid, Pugna tri-lane. I expect Pugna to be mid with the Alchemist CM Naix tri-lane. Aggressive? I guess it would depend on what Janitor picks at the end. We'll see. Again, Rubick is still in a pull. He's got a ton of good spells to steal. What else is there? Brain dead. Last track, but you don't really have a reliable stun. He does add a bit to the push. Chen, you could go that route because you mostly have a tri-lane range farmer. I wish I had the hero pool up for me. Lich was already taken out. Oh, Vengeful Spirit. Vengeful Spirit's pretty good. Can lock down, like, if Lifestealer is, like, banging on you, you could swap to save or swap to initiate. Man, I feel like I'm constipated or something. I need to go get my pop filter. Be right back, guys. Alright, got it. Just going to set up my pop filter real quick, so apologize for the disturbance in the mic and the banging around. Boop, boop, boop. 5 seconds remaining. Okay, it's a lion. Alright. Sorry about that. This pop filter, really annoying. All right, so I think I got my pop filter on. We'll see. It's a really weird setup. I actually don't know if I turned in my in-game mic. I haven't even turned in my in-game mic. So I apologize for you that are watching in-game. I forgot to turn on the Dota TV mic. You can still watch this on YouTube. I will post it somewhere soon. I can't tell if I want to use the RD2L VOD site. Seems like it's, like, I don't know, people don't pay enough attention to it. I have a hard time trying to upload videos because it keeps sending me to, like, some error messages. But yes, it's going to be Remorse mid on this Pugna. This will be very interesting to watch to see how it goes. It's actually going to be Death Prophet mid. Both sides are actually pretty even. I guess it'll depend on the base damage. That's a better date base damage. Oh, they're very even. Like one. So it's going to go 2-1-2. Windrunner with the Alchemist. That's not too bad. I guess both of them might share the farm. Yeah, that's cute. Nice courier. Just chilling around. So CM with the Naix. This is relatively survivable. CM, of course, can just go jungle. Not as cool with the CM set. It's not bad. I don't think it's bad. So Clockwork is going to go against this dual lane. This dual lane could possibly kill him, but actually I think Clockwork should have a decent time as well. He's got a stout shield. He should do all right. Janitor and Robo's man going top with the Razor. Yes, Razor is going to be the farmer instead of the Death Prophet. And I like this one. They could get easily. Because did Lion get Hex? Please get Hex. Well, he hasn't chosen yet. I guess he's just going to wait. Get Hex. A rune is bot. It's going to just be an illusion rune. That's not too shabby. Ooh, you can use the block camps. Sweet. Sweet for him. Janitor, is he going to go Hex and try to get a level 1 gank? Even if you do, like, there's no point. You can't kill the guy. So, level 1 Hex. Please go get level 1 Hex. Actually, Pugna got the better block, so he might have, he should have better CS. Do they see the 2-1-2? I don't, yes, they see the 2-1-2. Clockwork illusions are there. Probably needs to be a bit careful because he's going to pull the creep wave probably. No! No, why? I don't know. It just disappoints me a lot. Okay, Tombstone first. You should not go Tombstone first. You should almost always go Decay first. Level 1, Decay. Then level 2, Tombstone. Akay is just a better skill at level 1. Level 1 tombstone is actually kind of ass. You don't want that. And already, I think both these supports have picked the wrong skills early on. I just don't think they can pay off. This against a lane like this, they could easily get kills if they wanted to. They really could. And, oh no, Walnut also goes for the plasma field. What is this? I don't know. I feel like you have a much better chance getting kills if you had gone Decay for Robo's Man, and you had gone Static Link for Razor, and you had gone Hex for the Lion. But they'll have to somehow justify this. If they get the level 2, they need to get kills. Otherwise, this whole tri-lane's a waste. Finally, Static Link out. Probably looking to get someone. They need to pull the lane. Like, there's no way this Radiant side can contest it anyways. Yeah, just pull the lane. You got a much better chance of getting kills that way. Fiery Ice, let's see what he got. He was doing pretty well, but I mean, also Nayx is well, I mean, I don't expect either side to get kills. Both should do fine. And this way, I think Fiery Ice should be able to zone him out if you just spam the cogs, steal all his last hits. Oh no, I don't know if I like this build at all. I think Fiery Ice, especially if you're going against a melee carry, it's better to go Battery Assault. Pokemon, he pointed out. Oh, actually, this might be a problem. Should be out fine. But I think Battery Assault would have just been a better pick here. I mean, it will be very hard to kill Jorah because he does have the rage. But at the same time, Jorah has to be careful with the rage. He can't just willy-nilly throw it out. Once, I don't know if he'll even learn that there's no Battery Assault there. So looking at the farm, Jimmy, yeah, he is. He was Alchemist last time that basically won the Melk War. Oh, they're going to go right now. Where's the Lion? Lion is not there. Walnut, it's nearly dead, but he should be fine. Only had a level 1 power shot. Jimmy did spam out a lot of damage out there. They're going to make a go on the Clockwork. Clockwork, is he going to die? I'm not sure. He still has the cogs. Oh, cogged a bit too late. Just popped the battery, so just going to try to save himself. There's a rage. He does have a slow, but he wasn't in range of that slow. I'm surprised that could have been a kill if Jorah had done that. But he actually doesn't have the mana to pull that full combo. Mid lane, that's something we got to watch. Remorse has a DD rune. He should start pulling ahead NCS in this case. Oh, nice. Getting a bit of harass. Getting the last hits as well. Remorse doing quite well for himself. He's going to go for that max. In other words, it's like, the Crapify, who needs the Crapify? Probably will get one level Jorah. Wants to go on Fire Ice. They're not going to get the kill, but of course they're harassing him to death. And Crystal Maiden, once she hits level 3, most likely we'll get the Arcane Aura. I think it's worth it to just sap some EXP from Nyx at this point, just to get the level 3. Unless you're just like bossing it, getting these pulls going. Doesn't even mana for it. She should have it in about 4 seconds. Whoo-wee! But not rotation from the Alchemist. He does have a smoke. I don't know if they can do anything. It's a chase for the rune, but Alchemist is slow as hell. It's 339 moves, but it's actually looking not too bad. They might be able to catch him whatsoever. Are they going to get a regen rune? Oh, couldn't get the deny whatsoever. We'll try to toss it out. I don't think they're going to get the kill. They're just going to right click him. Right kick. It's Earth Spike is there. Hex as well. Not going to be able to get the kill. Not going to try to dive it. They're going to back out. But still, a good regen pickup for the Pugna, and they're going to force this Death Prophet to go back home. On the bright side, at least Lion will get some levels, and he needs it desperately. Level 3, what does he decide to go through? I think Mana Drain would be good. Yes, Mana Drain. It's like you heard me. Yeah. Well, bit of a shame there. Probably should have drained someone that was full health. Ooh, Janitor needed to be careful there. Remorse can kill him. Remember, he has a 2-level, 3-level advantage almost. And once that creep dies, he could go for it. Level 6 could go for Janitor. Is he going to go for it? He wishes he had Decrepify. He wishes he had Decrepify right there. But instead, he's going to push the Tier 2 tower. Death Prophet. Oh, man, this is so brutal. He has to walk back in lane. There's no point. Yeah, he has to walk back. He doesn't have anything on him. Robo's Man. I'm going to go on 1-up. 1-up might be in trouble. He can just Static Link and should be fine. Oh. Robo's Man just needs some more decay. Can't salvage, but should be fine. Oh, Jimmy's in a lot of trouble, actually. Those zombies. Clockwork just searching. He should be fine. Still no first blood. It's 5 minutes, 6 minutes, and almost. Clockwork doing not too bad, 19-0. But this lifestyle, oh man, is he gonna go Midas? That's a Midas. minus on him and 150 gold or like three last hits or two last hits, he'll have his Midas, and he's gonna go over here. I don't understand why he wants a contestant. The Invisrin is gonna be taken by Fiery Ice. It doesn't have cogs, or it doesn't have hook, so I don't think it would matter here. But Remorse, I think, is well aware that it's going to back up. It doesn't have anything. He could get the Tango. He's just gonna go back home. Just too scared of that right now. Hopefully, I don't miss first blood. Jimmy does have an unstable concoction. But it's going to be so hard to go against something like this. There we go. Midas, 6.5 minutes in for this Lifestealer. Oh, man. This farm's just going to go up and up and up. We'll see how this goes. Mana draining, cute. That's cute, but he needs to be super careful. If he gets picked out, he's going to die. Oh, God. Dang it. Oh, it's a double kill top. I miss it. Clockwork actually rotates in top with the cogs, Invis cogs. Wasn't expecting that at all. Lion actually just going to say bot and sap a lot of EXP. Ooh, Vanax very low. Very, very low. Oh, is Joran in range for this? He could. No, he's not in range for it quite yet. But the first two kills go in favor of Cleanup Crew. But of course, it's still this Lifestealer that's farming like a boss. Looking at the CS, all three Radiant heroes are on top of the CS chart, but I guess net worth tells a different story. That Clockwork is a second because he was involved with those two kills and got pretty decent farm. Remorse? No, he just wants to bang down that tower. Might get it pretty soon. Oh, faking, pump fake, acid spray. Yeah, now they're going to secure this tower. It's going to be hard to. Oh, no, there is a deny. It's not in deny range, but next time they will have it for sure. They're looking for the rune. It's an 8-minute rune. He wants it. Jorah is still farming away. Has, you know, 800, 8 minutes in. Pretty high GPM. What's his GPM? Current gold. No, that's current gold. That's dumb. Gold per minute, 358. And that's really high for 8 minutes in. I need to move back the net worth. There's three die here is mid. The clockwork. Was he there? Where's the clock? Yeah, clockwork is there. He's looking for a hook. Probably won't find it. Ooh, nice illusions just in case clockwork decides to man mode in. And they're going to try to push this instead. They want to protect this tier 1 tower just to its slightest undying decay. Undying decay is there. And they're going to go. Does have the tombstone. They could look to do something with this. Oh, careful. We're going to get some rotations. There's four. And here we go. Janitor is going to get bursted down quickly. Pugna is there. Oh, Alita might die as well. Oh, he's getting drained. Does he have? No, he doesn't have one. Instead, oh, Power Shot. Power Shot keeps him nearly hits him. They actually get a hook in. Vanek is there. Oh, Fiery Ice dodges. Oh, another unstable concoction actually picks out the Death Prophet. Big kill, actually. Big kill. Advantage. Oh, Shackle doesn't land because these trees are gone. A bit unfortunate for him. No mana for the tombstone. That's huge. I think if he had dropped the tombstone, he could have saved some people's lives. But and the bot tower gets destroyed by the Lifestealer. So now I have to say clearly advantage of the Radiant. Here we go. Yeah, 40 leading it. Big win there. They will take a tier 1 tower mid as well. They can't stop it. Pugna will just burst it down. One more. You can't even last it. Yo, throw out. Okay, they actually get it without doing that. Oh, I'm surprised he didn't go for it. But you know, Death Prophet is, you know, he doesn't have too much. Of course, it's just early on. He does have phase bottle. That's not too shabby. But he's died. Lost his tier 1 tower. And his team is quickly falling behind. This is a mid-game team. They don't really have a backup carry. I mean, Razor is that carry if you so are looking for one. But he's got like nothing so far. He's not going to be able to keep up with a Midas Lifestealer. And look at it. It's doubling the net worth. This Lifestealer is doubling the net worth of Walnut, the Razor carry. And this is not going to look good. Rotation from the winner. And they need kills badly. How are they going to do this? I'm not sure. Undying, as I've not felt his impact quite yet. Robozen taking some creeps right there. We'll buy an orb of venom. Is that, I don't know. Maybe you should just save it for like a bracer or a wand. I think wand would be good. Janitor might get caught out trying to get hex. That does actually throw that out. First janitor is in a lot of trouble. He looks to be dead. Janitor goes down, feeds his life away to Jorah. He's oh, so close to level 6. I'm sure he wanted that level 6 badly. He could even solo to CM if he had it. Hoo-wee. So looking at this. Oh, they're going to make a go. Nice shackle they do. Got a Robo's Mom. And 4-2 is the score. 4T leading in gold and EXP. 5K for gold. EXP, not that different of a story. And oh man, I got this huge urge to go play Pokemon. Jesus, like, I'm a freaking college student. I want to go play Pokemon. You know what? I'm going to do that right after this game, and I won't be, like, recording. I might. Jorah might be in trouble. Silence misses like a boss. And, oh, we'll try to suicide himself to the Ancients. Does get hexed up. Wow, they even throw the Death Prophet ulti. Does have the haste ring. Could look to just bang a tower down. No, wants the chase. Well, no. Oh, he gets the Crystal Maiden. Whoa, that burst damage. I wasn't expecting that at all. Does not. I wasn't expecting it. Now the ulti was useful. For a second there, I was like, what? Ulti for just a Niantic that was going to die anyways? But okay, they do get the Crystal Maiden with the Haste Rune, and that's got to be a very nice one. Now Elita is going to go and pick up an Invisor, and they're going to look for something now. Kill score is 4-4, and they finally slow down this Niantic's farm. Still, it's not enough. They got to kill him a couple more times, and no, they're going to go walnut. Going to throw it, does the unstable concoction, he's dead. Damn, that combo. Not sure why he didn't back up there. A bit confusing, but a good kill, nonetheless. It was textbook, wraparound, dive, tower, no expectation. Midas on the Alchemist, woo, greedy. Really falling for that Midas metagame of speed gaming and such. Well, we'll see. Maybe a medallion would have been slightly better. Medallion or drums or something. Has anybody on their team getting drums? Armlet up on the next 13 minutes. Armlet a bit slowed down because he did die earlier. Razor not having a good time. Actually, he's the one that's going to go for drums for his team, and he's actually just sitting in base. I guess he's just waiting, trying to see who to TP with. But the Dire, they might be pushing top. Even though Undying bought the urn, he's just not had any urn charges in like forever. It does give you nice mana regen, better than nothing, but he's just no impact. I felt none of it. It's only one. He's 1-1-1. I don't know. The pick is nice, but they didn't get a lot of early game kills, which is where he strives. Crystal Maiden TPing top. Let's see what she's got. And there might be an engagement. There's most definitely going to be an engagement. Alchemist Jimmy might be in trouble. Is there going to be a Hex? Yes, Hex. Finally, someone gets a combination right. Can't look to burst him down with the ulti. No, that has no mana. Instead, Janitor might die. No, gets saved by the cogs. Shackle doesn't land. Oh, Nevron Pug comes in the back to pick off the line. That's the first casualty. Jimmy is to die soon afterwards. But it's getting hectic. Pugna's in trouble. Never mind. No, he's not. He's got the lifesteal. Oh my gosh. Jorah's just eating him alive. It doesn't matter. That's two dead already. Death Prophet has a DD bottle. He's going to go top. Does have his ultimate, but doesn't want to break high ground through there. Could look to re-engage. Lion will be back up soon. He still has his finger. Could look to TPN or just walk around. The tower will go down. They're going to glyph it. Lion is back up. They really want to go. Do they have Clockwork Hook? They don't have Clockwork Hook, but he might just try to man mode this. The Prophet ulti. Here we go. Once again, silence. No, why you no silence, man? Why you no silence? Trying to get there, but Janitor is so freaking slow. Silence would have been nice. Hex. Oh, why you know Hex? And then does throw that down and said Fire Ice is going to get turned around. There's a Crystal Maiden ulti. Where's the silence? Doesn't have the mana for the silence. Crystal Maiden ulti actually did a lot of damage. Fire Ice trying to TP out. We'll get out just fine. Jukes them around the trees. Yes, he's fine. Could not do anything. Bit unfortunate there, but still a good trade for the Radiant side. I thought they were stronger. They had a better laning experience. Maybe I don't think they had the better lanes, but they just had a better laning experience. Undying, was he able to drop the tombstone? I couldn't remember. He has like no mana, and he's going to scale off really hard. It's only going to get worse for him as things go. He can't tank. He can't do too much of anything else. Clockwork, I mean, he's the only one that had like a decent start on his side. It was involved in a double kill. He actually go Midas. first. Okay, so that's pretty greedy, but he wants to try to keep up in levels. This is against Midas Gaming. We'll see how this goes. I mean, there's still that mid-game lineup, and Wannald just could not feel his presence at all, and oh man. Besides the max of Plasma Field first, Static Link is really good, but I guess he just wants the magical damage. Fiery Ice barely survives that one. Jorah, he's gonna go for Basher. Like, YOLO mode. Just wanna like bash people, snipe them, and eat their brains out. And there we go. More gold for him. 8,500 net worth. That's pretty ridiculous. 2 1-on-1, almost 100 CS. That's pretty ridiculous. Not the complete best farm, but definitely up there. Definitely up there. It's a farm that you would like as a carry. Pugnam, meanwhile, has finished level 2 Necromonicon. Whoa, I'm impressed. Where did you find this farm, Remorse? Taking towers, getting kills, being involved, and yeah, has been overall impressive. He's been good. Both games been very solid. Almost makes me wish I wish my team had drafted him. But Jimmy banging out a tower with that Midas. Needs to back up and probably need the Midas something. Scared, I'm sure. But the money's, you know, working out for him. He maxed out the concoction, so that's not too shabby. He's going to go back for Grievous Green, not really caring too much. And yeah, they have the lead. But now the Dire, they're going to push top. But instead, the Radiant, they're pressuring two towers, and Pugna might die. No, can't get the life drain off. Oh, they get the life. Oh, they do. They solo kill each other. Where did that come from? Dire's bottom tower is what? Under attack. Clockwork, how did you die? Radiant's top tower is under attack. Where's that? Hey, you guys, doing some great I can't combat log. Alright, whatever. Meanwhile, I need to get this out of the way. Shoot fly. Did Clockwork kill a Necromonicon and it killed himself? It almost looked like a Dagon, but I know for sure Pugna doesn't have a Dagon. But that's level 3 Necromonicon. I think it was because he killed a Necromonicon and killed himself that way. Pretty hilarious. Still, I mean, offlaner for your Pugna mid is not too shabby, especially with Pugna that far ahead. Who killed who first? The Clockwork killed Pugna first, so he got the EXP, so that's not too bad. Alita is also going for the Necromonicon. Only level 1 though. Pugna is level 3, so whew, this could be the defining moment. Wards will no longer be on the map for this poor Dire side. Razor not having a good time, trying to work on the drums. I think he's got it. There we go. Drums on him. He is a bit more tanky. He is a bit more speedy. Could look to counter. I mean, he can still dish out some damage. And man, they're just taking a tower. Walnut's just like not giving a crap. Alita. Not gonna do much about it. They're gonna chase. Jimmy throws all that. Oh my God, Robo's on. Hook from the Clockwork, saving his buddy. But Jimmy will be. Oh, finally, there is a tombstone. Jimmy's in trouble. Fiery Ice is even more trouble. Oh no, both teams are so dead. Clockwork finally passes out. Pugna was picked off somewhere in the back. But player 704 is in a lot of trouble. A lot of trouble. Will they be able to get him? There's a lightning plasma field. Yes, this looks to be death. He knows it's death. Tries to shackle. For Amazing Light of Heaven doesn't work out too much. And there's a TP out from Jimmy. Vanek? Janitor wants it. Trying to give him some vision. Lifestealer is there. He could look to turn around. He does have a hex. Oh, Vanek will die from the Earth Spike instead. Alita's going to chase him down. No, they're going to try to get the tier 1 tower. They've turned things around slightly. They've traded 2 for 3, I believe. Actually, maybe just 1 for 3. Yeah, Clockwork, I think, was the only casualty. And Undying Tombstone finally felt like it was doing something. Before, it was just kind of weak sauce. And he's going to go for Vlad's. I like this pickup. Well, it gives you aura. Yeah, it definitely gives you some push aura. As for lifesteal, mostly Clockwork and Undying would benefit from it. Though Clockwork, you know, he's going for eggs. It'd be pretty good. He might have it in about 3-4 minutes, maybe 5, if he can get some good farming and some nice pickoffs. But Prophet's ulti is down, and she's top, actually. She has a level 2 Necromonicon, and they're just going to pressure again. The Light of Heaven is there. They do get the line, and Robozomen is dead as well. Are they going to push? No, they're just going to try to take all the tier outer tier towers. 20 minutes in, no, actually, they want to break high ground. They're like, screw you guys. We have Necromancon level 3. I have Pugna Blast. I have Ward. Walnut trying to dish the deeps, but Mech has popped out as well. So kind of negates it just a little bit. They will bang the tower down just a bit. Jimmy needs to be back. Careful, needs to be careful. Is going. Oh, Clockwork Cook is there, Jimmy. Goodbye. Yeah, try to force staff him out. Who had to force staff? Oh, I think one winner did, yeah. And there's the own Necromonicon. Kind of looks like a super ugly Meepo. Damn. Damn, son. Whew. And both sides with kind of like pushing heroes could easily take some towers, although the Radiant had been way more successful at it. There's only one outer tower left for the Dire side. And the gold advantage, man, it's looking pretty bad. Over 10k for gold, and EXP, it's over 7,500. And the Lifesteader is still farming. He wasn't even involved in any of that. He's going to go for AC, finish up the Basher, looking for the AC. And whew, how do you stop this guy? I mean, you have to get a nice silence. You have to get a brilliant cogs, and you'll have to just burst him down and hope for the best from there. He's still not very tanky. Only 1,300. Of course, when he turns on the armlet, it'll be about 1,700. Or maybe like 1,600. I don't know. I can't do math. I'm just like pretending guesstimation type things. Trying to get denied, didn't get it. That's maddening. They do have the Necro Book. They can, yes, they're going to make a go on this. Lifesteader needs to probably start heading up there as well. Or they really feel confident they can take this. Clockwork is still there. He's like the main savior of this team so far. Fiery Ice. Oh, they get a nice ward over there. Jimmy goes in, throws a very good concoction. But, it gets hexed up. Will not die. Instead, Lions. In Light of Heaven, Clockwork will die as well. They're just going to bang down the tower. But Alita is here. Are they going to go? Are they going to keep going? They're going to keep going. Alita, don't get shackled. Don't get shackled. Power Shot is their janitor. Is still, of course, very low. Meanwhile, on the backside, Jimmy's surviving, but it's going to his teeth. He still does have his wand. Trying to get another concoction out. Can't pop it. Light of Heaven. Once again, Alita's going to go down, though. These Windrunner Shackle Shots have been so amazing. Walnut is going to die as well, I think. Earth Spike is there. Never mind. Walnut, Power Shot. Power Shot misses. Just barely. Robo's Man is in a lot of trouble. Finally, Undying Tombstone is there. And Jimmy, is he gonna get blocked in? No, he should be fine. Oh no, they've dove too far. Remorse might be in trouble. Will slow unstable concoction. Just need one more right click. They need the vision. Right click. There we go. Wind Ranger gets the kill. Vanik will run away. They've basically nearly gotten the tower now. They're still just gonna mammo Jimmy. It's taking a Clockwork Hook. Clockwork doesn't have a Clockwork Hook. Doesn't have anything. Lifestealer, meanwhile, has taken that tier 3 tower. Rax will fall for them. Here we go. Easiest Rax of his life. He's like, thanks team. 2-1-1, only been involved with 3 kills. How often do you see this happen? He's gonna rage away. He probably should have just rage TP. Might be too late. Oh, just get up just in time. Clockwork didn't have hooks, so there's no way they can disrupt it. And they're going to get a second tier 3. They lose the melee racks. They're going to lose a second tier 3. And oh my gosh, how much space did this team create? Those shackle shots have been so good. In that top lane, they needed it, and they got it. Like, how much more could you have asked? Oh wow, this ward dishing out a lot of damage. But they really want to go. Nope. I'm not going to try to protect it. They're happy with this trade. Don't want to throw anything. Oh, mass simultaneous TPs. Oh man. That's a sign of synchronized... Oh shit, synchronization. all on the same page. Remorse picks up the boots of travel, and well, there it is. There is Mjolnir on this Lifestealer. Jeez, snuck up on us, took towers, took racks, and they're leading very convincingly at this moment. 20k gold, 14k EXP. I don't see them coming back. Undying does absolutely. Huh? What happened to his items? Okay. Cute. Well, can't even throw anything. Maybe just dies. Those nice tombstone won't do anything for you. As we saw, I mean, max tombstone doesn't do anything at this point. These guys are really fat. They're going to take this Undying. What did you do with all his items? Those are Undying's items, right? Yeah, those are all Undying's items. I guess he's going to try to finish up the Vlad's. There we go. Roshan probably going to get picked off right here. Plasma filled. And they're trying to go on 704, but no go. Alchemist Stun can't get it off right now because he's silenced forever. We'll stun him. Well, barely gets a stun off right now. Walnut is in a lot of trouble, but it's still a lot. Whoa! Crystal Maiden ulti, defensive purposes, but it's not defensive if you die. Oh my god. There's a finger from the lion, and they get their first kill in seemingly a super long time. Alita throwing out the ulti just for this. Are they going to go for this? They're going to keep going. The Pokemon were dishing out a lot of damage. Just now disappeared not too long ago. Jora farming away. 2-1 on 1. Trying to beat Jules' record. Well, you can't because he was 0-0-0 and it still won the game. And there we go. They killed the Pugna. Is this the time for the comeback? I don't know. They could look to push off of this. Pugna is dead. Alchemist is dead. But, you know, you still got to take into account Jora. Like, he's just doing so much. 1500 HP levels up once again. Jesus. Like, what more can I say? Wow, look at that. Doubling with Death Prophet, who's leading the Dire team in CS. And yes, they want to go for the Rex. Lindyne's still walking around with no items. I don't know if that's a mistake. Is he going to throw down the tombstone? Will he be able to get out? Jimmy is going to throw that. Is he going to get another Cogs out? Light of Heaven? Probably not. Light of Heaven? Oh, that looked good. Is he going to throw down the... He actually throws down the tombstone. Just don't know how much that's going to do for you. Drums get picked up from the... Death Prophet, I guess, just wants to survive. Undying looks to be dead. Can't even do anything. Feeds his life away. We'll run. Are they going to get a silence? Alchemist is going to stun himself. Yep, stuns himself. Jora, wow. 106 plus 97 without the armlet on. Still has the Aegis. I think they're just going to push mid. Yep. Like, why not? I mean, you have bottles. You have everything. Oh, who's going to last at it? Okay. And Jora can just sacrifice himself. They can't kill him a second time. I know for sure. I'm not so positive they can even kill him a third time. First time. Okay, so he's going to activate his armlet very soon. He's going to go. Here we go. Tower, tier 3 tower. The third one and last one. Gets Siege. Elite throws out his ultimate. I just don't know what they can do. Do they have the Pugna Ward? Yes, Pugna Ward is down. It's dishing a lot. Here we go. They take the last tier 3 tower of the Dire side. No Light of Heaven this time. But they're going to get Alita. Alita looks to be dead. Yes, right click. Oh my god. 3-shot. And a power shot to KS on by Wind Ranger. He's going to... Oh my god. Look at that. There's 3 dead. I wouldn't be surprised if they just called it GG or play it out just for fun. This is the last game of the night for this team. 2 racks down. Soon to be Mega Creeps. Buyback from Undying. Still no items. I guess he's basically given up. He knows. He's just basically running around naked. Why would you ever run around naked? Ooh, are they going to try to go? Oh, Light of Heaven, Robozon. Oh, man. There we go. Oh, Crystal Maiden ulti. Everything. Clockwork is dead as well. He has the hook. No, nice cogs. Nice cogs. Crystal Maiden. Does get it. Oh, blade mail. No. Team wipe. And there we go. They're going to finish off the last set of racks. This looks to be a very impressive victory for 4T. I wasn't so convinced with the early Death Prophet pick. And I think the Dire could have won their tri lane much, much harder. And Jora, ooh, he should be fine. He's Aegis and everything. He can even just sacrifice himself. Yeah, there we go. He's going to sacrifice himself. Let's see if he can solo too. No, they're all just running away. Mega creeps for the Radiant side. There we go. And what was I going to say? Yeah, I don't think they lost too badly in the draft. First game was, of course, very amazing. I hope you guys get to watch that. And we've seen this before. GG gets called. Congratulations to 4T. 2-0-ing Cleanup Crew. First game was definitely an impressive one. Second game could have been a bit better. Still, Clockwork Hook trying to pick up the supports. Not going to get it. Light of Heaven not there. Blade Mail not going to do you too good on that. killed by the Life Sailor. There we go, GG. So much space was made for the Life Sailor. And I guess they're just going to let the Ancients fall. And I guess, yeah, I'll just do this real quick. Yeah. Just going to play it out like this. They really want to get more kills. Pack up some stacks. Get those fantasy points. And yeah, we actually do have some fantasy points. Thanks to Remorse, who's playing this game. There we go. Well, that was a very interesting series. Definitely game one is one for you guys to watch. And Robo's man is not too happy about not having Vision. Oh well. All right, well, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I also hope you guys join me next time.